Hi, I'm Laura Pruden with Variety, and I'm here with Michael Cudlitz of The Walking Dead. Thank you for being with us, Michael.
Thanks for having me.
The last time we saw Abraham and the rest of the group, they were trapped in a train car. So what can you preview about where they'll go from here?
The shared mission now is to get out of the train car. Mm-hmm. You know, I still have an overriding mission to get Eugene to Washington. I'm trying to get as many people to come with me as possible. That's why I wound up going to Terminus with Glenn and his group, because I wanted to see if I could convince them to come with me. And we had no real viable option for transportation at the time, so it seemed like it made sense to make this detour if we were going to possibly get something out of it in the way of more support and people who could help us.
Tomorrow we go to the end of the line, then Washington.
That mission has not changed, but there's a more immediate mission of staying alive and getting out of the car, and we all share that. You know, so even though that group doesn't necessarily have an overriding goal or mission pulling them through other than staying alive and Rick keeping his family together, right now we have a shared mission to just survive and get out of the car.
You're screwing with the wrong people.
How important do you think it is for Abraham to have this mission? Obviously that's something that the rest of the group hasn't really had
him
up to this point.
Yeah, it completely defines him at this point. And we'll learn throughout the season as to why, what drives him, what his reasons are for survival, what his motivations are for taking on this mission, and what he has left behind.
When we get to Washington, we will make the dead die, and the living will have this world again.
Tara made a note at the end of last season that Abraham seems to enjoy killing a little bit. He kind of takes pleasure from kicking Walker ass, which, you know, is a valid life choice. Why do you think that is? What is driving him?
I think it's more than, I think he sort of clicks over. There's this sort of warrior that he becomes when he's doing that, and I don't think he's really aware of it. I think she points out something that they see something in each other. They can call, you know, bull crap on each other.
Get the whole gung-ho, mission is your life bullshit.
Yeah, you do.
I think he's a good judge of people when he sees them. He sees right through them, and I think that he was caught. And something that he doesn't even necessarily know how to explain. It doesn't feel like he has to, but just buries it, pushes her aside with this comment, you know, I'm the happiest man in the world, luckiest man in the world, and moves forward.
I like to fight.
Rick and Abraham are obviously both alpha males, both leaders. Will we see them butting heads? How do they kind of react to each other once they're in the group together?
You know, in the trailer you see some stuff, so obviously there's some conflict. There is no sort of conflict on the outset just because of who they are and what they're doing, because they don't have conflicting missions, you know, and Abraham could really care less what these guys want to do. He's going to try to get them to come over to his side to do what he feels is important, but if not, he's going to move ahead. It's like, you don't want to do it, that's, you know, great, but don't get in my way. Then we'll have problems.
Abraham's also bringing in a sense of hope and this sense of purpose, as you mentioned, for the rest of the group. How important do you think keeping hope alive is in this very bleak world?
I think hope is the most important thing. I think once hope is lost in the show's not worth watching anymore. I think because you've lost at that point. I think hope is one of the main driving factors of the show and has been from the beginning. However small it may be, or for however large the hopes might be that get dashed, I think that there's always renewed hope, and that is what pulls everybody through to whatever's next. There has to be hope.